Hello and welcome to the first virtual all-around Azure IoT event. That's your getting started on IoT technologies and on your way to getting certified. And today, joining me, I have Sam George, our CVP for engineering for Azure IoT. I am Olivier Bloch. I am a technical PM in the Azure IoT engineering team looking after communities. How about you, Sam? Give us a little introduction about yourself.
Yeah, Sam George, been at Microsoft quite some time, former developer myself. So developers are very near and dear to my heart. Thrilled to be with you today.
Thanks, Sam. So today, Sam would like to give you a little bit insight about, you know, why you should care about this event. Why would you want to become an Azure IoT certified engineer, and why would you want to go through the topics that we have today for you? But before we go there, think about this event as your launch pad on your way to becoming certified for Azure IoT. You'll get some learnings today about how to connect a device all the way up, how to integrate with business application, how to bring ML at the edge and apply on IoT data. But all of that obviously is in the context of you know, how the business is evolving and how things are growing. And so, Sam, what about, you know, the ecosystem and how is the landscape looking these days for IoT?
Yeah, well, one of the great things about being a developer in IoT now is that businesses around the world have recognized the benefit of IoT. You know, IoT gives you visibility into all physical aspects of your business in real time, and businesses just didn't have that insight before. But at the same time, it requires a pretty sophisticated level of development, everything from embedded development to edge computing to cloud solution development to biz app development, and, you know, everything that we've been working so hard to provide over the last 5 years makes that easier and easier and easier. So, you know, there's really never been a better time to be a developer in IoT. The technology's ready, and there's a tremendous amount of demand for developers in IoT.
Yeah. And what's interesting is, so not only IoT solutions span from these devices all the way up to the business applications, and that means that you have different types of software engineers that need to be involved, you know, to build the device on one side, to connect it, to work on the networking, on the security, but also on the web side of things, right? The dashboarding and the use of the cloud services backend. So lots of different software engineers are not involved. So hence, one more reason for people actually to learn about IoT, even if their background is not embedded development. There's also a dimension which I find really interesting in what we're evolving, is that it's not just software engineers. Now you need to work with data scientists. You need to work with, you know, chemical or physical or mechanical engineers. Yeah. So it's pretty interesting. And you know, in that context, Sam, I'd like for you to get people excited if they're not familiar with IoT applications and solutions. What's your favorite IoT solution out there?
Well, it's hard to say one particular favorite. There's so many that are happening right now. But one of them that I'll talk about briefly is one by a great company in New York City called RXR Realty. And they've developed a solution that is, people are coming back into their buildings, into offices, to help keep people safer in this time of COVID-19. And what it really shows, what this RX Well solution, they call it, shows, is how IoT, edge computing, AI, and cloud can really help provide solutions that help keep people safer. So what RX Well does is it uses cameras running our edge computing platform, IoT Edge, that are mounted in various parts of the building, as well as sensors. And what it does is it ensures that, number one, people are wearing masks, that they're ensuring safe social distancing, they're staying 6 feet apart or not, that, you know, different parts of the building aren't being overly crowded, there's not too many people in one particular area. It's also tied into the building infrastructure itself, so it ensures that there's high airflow, for example, in the building. So all of this winds up meaning that instead of having to go around and manually ensure people are wearing masks and safe social distancing and things like that, that the building tenants and the administrators just start getting alerts when they're not. And then they can go and help, you know, just sort of remind folks to be safe. So all of this is combined then to help really keep people safer in an automated fashion. And it's a great testament to the power of IoT and edge computing and AI all working together.
Nice. And so actually, it makes me think, you know, can you give us a little bit insight into what is it that Azure IoT is providing? So customers are implementing these end-to-end solutions, but how do we contribute? What is our role in all of that?
Yeah, so let's talk about the RX Well solution. And I'll talk about just briefly the different areas. We provide everything from everything in the cloud. So we have our Azure IoT Hub cloud service, which is used for connecting to and managing those millions of devices, sending trillions of messages. We have data services, we have business application integration services. You'll hear all about those today. But then out on the edge, we also have our edge computing platform, Azure IoT Edge, that helps developers run cloud services such as AI workloads directly on devices themselves, as well as SDKs for running on devices themselves, down to the very tiniest of devices. So we have Azure RTOS that runs on devices with as little as 50 kilobytes of memory. We have Azure Sphere, which provides a safe and secure endpoint that's monitored by Microsoft and always up to date. And then we have a device SDK that runs on virtually every operating system in IoT on the planet, in every language popular language developers are using today. All of that is open source and broadly supported by our team.
Nice. And on the cloud side of things, we talk a lot about integrating with business applications and so on. So how does that work up there?
Yeah, we make that super, super easy with offerings like Azure Logic Apps, as well as Power Automate. So those two tools, Power Automate and Logic Apps, provide connectors to well over 250 business integration systems, and not just by Microsoft, you know, lots and lots and lots of different services, SAP, Salesforce, and on and on. And so as a signal is detected in the physical world and you need to alert some business process, we make that really, really easy to integrate with.
Nice. And in our goal to simplifying IoT, so we're building all these Lego blocks, right, to build your own solution. But we also are offering IoT Central, right? Can you give us a little bit, of insights about what is IoT Central and what is it meant for?
So all of the different almost building block platform services that I just covered so far, you can assemble them just like RXR did into these solutions that help fuse the physical world and the digital world and provide insights in real time. What we've learned in our time in market is that not every company has the development skills that are required to do that. And so what we've done is we've put together an offering called Azure IoT Central. And what Azure IoT Central does is it uses all of those different cloud services that I was covering and more. But it puts it together in a very simple to use SaaS offering with a super predictable price per device pricing that gets cheaper and cheaper the more devices that you use. You don't have to worry about assembling those cloud services or scaling them up independently. You simply connect devices to it. You can connect devices in just minutes. And as you add devices, Azure IoT Central uses all of those services, automatically scales up. It provides out of the box, rich dashboards, analytics, and then also business process integration. So it takes advantage of Power Automate Logic Apps. It has continuous data export, so you can export all of your data on an ongoing basis from IoT Central to downstream Azure services. So we've made it super easy. We like to say that IoT Central enables you to connect devices in just minutes, go to production the same day, and scale to any amount of devices, all without needing cloud solution development skills.
Yeah, I've been pretty amazed by the amount of features that are now in IoT Central. Actually, one that is super important for our developers is the APIs that IoT Central exposes. It's not a black box. It's something that you can develop with and around and integrate into your solution end to end. Sam, what about what's coming next? What's the vision? Where are we going with all of that?
Yeah. So if you step back and look at what's happening in the industry right now, IoT has really gained mainstream adoption over the last 5 years. And the primary use of IoT has been to find insights from, you can think of it as insights from assets, right? HVAC machines or water pumps or elevators, you know, to find the maintenance needs, to predict those maintenance needs, to gain insights from those. But it's really been geared towards the assets themselves. And what we're starting to see now in IoT is that as IoT becomes more and more mainstream, that companies are wanting to connect entire environments. So for example, I'll pick on manufacturing. They're interested in not just connecting to the manufacturing assets, right? The bottling machines or the milling machines or the welding machines. They're interested in connecting to the entire environment, the building itself, all of the people that are in it, the inbound supply chain, the outbound distribution network, and to find insights from that entire environment. And so just late last year, we made generally available Azure Digital Twins. And what Azure Digital Twins is it enables you to model entire environments. So you can model them first, then you can connect IoT sensors as well as other business signals to Azure Digital Twins. And what Azure Digital Twins does is it effectively builds a live distributed object model that represents that physical environment, and then it enables you to data bind to the physical environment. And then as the physical environment changes, Azure Digital Twins raises events, you handle those events, you implement business logic. So Digital Twins is really the next stage of the evolution of these connected solutions. And then just over the horizon, we start to see businesses starting to partner over the insights that they gain in these connected environments and to provide really, you know, intelligent ecosystems that all work together. So it's an incredibly exciting time. We've made it really easy. And it's a great time to be a developer in IoT.
Nice. Yeah. And actually, interesting, you mentioned Digital Twins as the hero next big, you know, feature or service over here, because I've seen actually lots of different types of engineers very interested in the use of digital twins. Like when you come from a different background, you're not a software engineer, you need to have this level, this graph that allows you to rapidly ingest all that data from various sources. And they don't want to build or having to build these blocks, these things that are not, you know,
it's complicated plumbing. It's hard to get right. You know, it took us several years to get it to market because it's so complicated. But what's nice is that now we've simplified that, and you can simply model in a very flexible language we call the digital twin definition language. You can simply model that any environment, the relationships between things, send that to Azure Digital Twins, and we'll materialize that distributed object model for you.
I like that. What are we doing to simplify how solution developers connect devices? Like, I know devices is something that is complex by nature. Also, when you want to connect devices from various types, various manufacturers, various places, well, they all come up with their own protocol, their own language, their own way of exposing their data. So what are we doing in that space to help developers integrate their devices with the devices from other companies, partners, whatnot, into their solutions?
Yeah, well, one of the challenges that we saw over the last 5 years in IoT is that there's this incredibly tight coupling between software that runs on the device and software that runs in the solution. So as an example, if your device is hard-coded to send temperature and humidity and vibration, your cloud solution has to be hard-coded to receive temperature and humidity and vibration. And often there's even an expectation about how frequently it sends. And so, you know, in early IoT, honestly, that wasn't a problem. But what IoT is starting to bump up against is that device providers are now wanting to provide devices that can be used generally in lots of different solutions, not just one. And solution providers are wanting much easier onboarding experiences for devices, where they're not effectively having to just go down to bare metal on the device and hard code a bunch of sensor information that's coming from the device. So as part of our push last year on digital twins, we introduced and made generally available what we call IoT Plug and Play. And what IoT Plug and Play is very simple. It uses the digital twin definition language to help developers, device providers, explain or to attest what capabilities the device has, what telemetry it sends, what state that it can synchronize, what commands that it receives, and the responses that it sends from those commands and things like that. And that's all packaged up in the digital twin definition language for the device that uses the digital twin definition language. Now, when the device first connects, it sends a pointer to its document for this digital twin definition language document. And then the solution can simply automatically adjust to what the device can do. So we showed a demo, and I think we'll be showing that as part of this series, showed a demo where you can simply take a device that Azure IoT Central, for example, has never seen before. And as the device is connected and goes through our device provisioning service into IoT Hub, which is being used by IoT Central, IoT Central automatically shows a dashboard for the device. It shows all the different data fields that the device is sending, the telemetry, any of the state that it can synchronize, the commands that it can receive, all without writing a single line of code in the cloud to configure it. So it's a super powerful way, effectively, to program IoT devices.
Love it. Love it. Well, I hope that we have everyone's attention here. Before we wrap up, Sam, besides having us learn to work remotely and record this kind of events online, right, and also deliver that to more people where, you know, from the home, do you see any impact from COVID and the pandemic on the IoT business itself?
Yeah, for sure. In fact, we've seen an acceleration. You know, most companies, we do this signals report. We call it the IoT Signals Report, where we go and survey businesses from around the planet, about 3,200 different businesses. And what we're seeing in general from all of those businesses is that for businesses that were getting started with IoT or that already had an IoT solution, IoT has, in fact, accelerated. It's much, much, much faster. Now, of course, some of the businesses where they were lights out, where they weren't able to get to, you know, they hadn't done that, an IoT solution yet, and they were unable to get to their physical premises. Of course, that had an impact. But even there, we're starting to see return to work and people getting going. So all up, it's really had an accelerating impact on IoT. So again, another great reason to be an IoT developer.
Yeah, so time to wrap up. Thanks, Sam, a lot for your time and your insights. We really hope we have your attention and that you understand how important having skilled IoT engineer is for the business these days. It's really for you an opportunity to grow in your career. We have a bunch of content for you today, but once again, do not stay at just the event of today. We consider that as your launchpad to becoming an Azure IoT certified engineer. And so for that, we have a 30 days to learn it challenge, which is available for you at this link. And what that is a set of self-paced, you know, IoT learning courses that you will have to go through. And if you make it in these 30 days, you will receive a 50% off on a Microsoft IoT certification exam. So I think it's really worth it. And once again, on your way to becoming certified, do not forget to sign up. It's this link or at the bottom of the All Around Azure event. Sam, once again, thanks a lot for your time. Enjoy the event today, and I hope to see you soon. Bye.
Thanks, everyone.